Good morning, everyone. Previous class, we had been learned that social process process means step by step events. We have been interacting with each other and experiencing different types of social phenomenon or social process. Sometimes we have been cooperate with each other and compete with each other, competition, then conflict, then accommodation. So this is a events in every individual life. That's why we have to think about the social process is a life. Life events. Mainly we had covered types of social process and cooperation, competition over. Conflict as well as we had been studied. Today we have to start with types of conflict. Before I would like to ask questions. Abisha or
yes sir,
can you list what are the disassociative social processes? What are the social process is disassociative? Can you see in the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Competition, conflict, isolation.
Excellent. Okay, thank you for your nice answer, Abisha. So today I like to start with types of conflict. Students, the study of conflict is I learned in psychology. In psychology, study about conflict in the mind. Here we have to emphasize about conflict between the two individuals or conflict between two groups. But fact is that every conflict started from individual mind only. First conflict, personal conflict, interpersonal, intrapersonal. The interpersonal means a conflict within the mind, which may be called as psychological conflict. Intrapersonal, between the individuals. Second, racial conflict. Conflict between two racial groups, black, white, Aryans and Dravidians. Then class conflict between two classes, upper class, middle class. Next, political conflict between two political parties. Example, next type, political conflict. Conflict between two political parties. For example, AIADMK, DMK. For national level aspect, Congress, BJP, is conflict between them due to political purpose. Then international conflict between two nations, or among the, for example, conflict between China and India. In generally, there are two types of conflict: latent conflict and overt conflict. Then corporate conflict and personal conflict. The latent conflict means a conflict invisible, which is within the mind. It may be called as psychological conflict. Corporate means conflict between two big organizations. Personal conflict means conflict between two individuals, persons. Then conflict episode. Students, so this knowledge is very important for us to manage the conflict in everyday life. As we know that we have been experiencing conflict in everyday life, you know, which cause stress and destruction, relationships, etc. So how this start the conflict? First, conflict started with latent. Latent means invisible, we can't see in the society, which is available in every individual mind. As we had learned types of conflict in psychology, approach to approach, avoidance to avoidance, double approach to avoidance, like this. Then perceived conflict. I would like to give one illustration. Conflict between two persons due to the financial issue. For example, two individuals done a job and 1,000 rupees. The rationally, both of them need 500 and 500. But person A bring more money for that work, for example 750 rupees, and only 250 rupees only given to person B. What will happen? The person B experiencing the conflict towards person A due to financial matter. The perceived means, for example, if a person B see the person A, the person A didn't given enough money for their work. So they experiencing conflict, perceive through eyes, you know, perception through eyes. When they talk anything about that, experiencing the conflict, this perceived conflict, they through perception, through their ears, eyes, and senses, and experiencing the conflict. Third one, felt conflict. Felt means feeling. After perception, we feel about. When you feel conflict, what you may be experiencing, you know, what you feel, felt. Change our facial expressions. Eyes may be red in color. And try to conflict with other persons and feeling their own. Fourth one, manifest conflict. So this area only, this episode only, dangerous place, dangerous episode. After the feeling, display behavior. May be using bad words against others or beat with each other, and that conflict may be ended with bloodshed and murder, as well as fight with each other. Fifth one, conflict aftermath. Every conflict ended with resolution. So fifth episode is that, try to solve the conflict in different manner. So students, how to solve, how to manage the conflict in everyday life? First suggestion is that just think about latent conflict. You know, thinking. When you think conflict, just resolve that conflict within the mind. Then pursue. When you see a person, perceive conflict due to various reasons. What will we do? Go to fight with that person? Never, you know, when we feel, just away from that situations. When we perceive and feel, away from that situation and create good feeling and try to avoid that conflict. My suggestion is that don't go to this episode. It means conflict behavior, which create destruction and break down the relationships. Maybe we know that fight ended with blood shedding and injuries, etc. So clear about it? So within the 6 episodes, we need to control the conflict to prevent further or overt conflict. Then role of conflict. First role, stiffen the moral. Moral means right things. Through conflict we can identify what are the rights and wrong in a particular setting. Second, promote solidarity. The question is that, is conflict promote solidarity? Yes. From the conflict we can learn something. Learn something. So healthy or moderate level of conflict we can promote solidarity. Third one, enlargement of victory groups. Every conflict ended with some destruction and break down the relationships. So that persons can join with other groups and enlargement and develop their performance. Fourth one, redefining value system. Individual values have been redefined through the conflict. Which means moderate level of conflict. Severe conflict ended with the destructions, and so moderate level of conflict can support us redefine the values. Fifth one, working out non-violent. The conflict due to land, people learn about overt conflict cause injuries and destructions in the life. So that can people learn to prevent that type of conflict and promote healthy conflict, which means they agitate against others the non-violent manner. Conflict with others, non-violent manner. Sixth one, change in the relative status. Status between the two groups, between two individuals, two organizations, etc. Seventh one, most important role, new consensus. Every conflict can teach us lesson and provide new ideas. How to rearrange the life, rearrange the group functions. So fact is that the conflict is essential. It's conflictless life is essential. So conflict is part of life. So in the life, if any time you can experiencing the conflict, don't worry about it. So we can control the conflict and manage the conflict and improving our status, and we can learn from that conflict new ideas and create ourselves and promote sustainable development towards self as well as groups in the society. So clear about it? Then effects of conflict. First effect, integration effect. Define issues. So every conflict can help us to identify what are the real issues in the particular setting, in family setting or in workplaces, etc. Next, leads to resolution of issues. The conflict only provide way or provide path to to solve the problems in the society. That leads to alliances with other groups, which means one group maybe create this conflict or disagreement between them. What will do? That group may be cut off that relationship with that groups and join with other groups, which is better than previous. This is integrative effect. Next, group alertness. Without conflict, the members of group difficult to alert regarding their group activities and group goals and objectives. So small conflict help us. Every members alert regarding their group objectives and try to achieve it. Then disintegrative effect. Increase bitterness. Irritation. You know, we know the disagreement between two individuals. Then destruction and bloodshed. Injuries, you know. Next effect, tension. Group tension, intergroup. Next, disintegrative effect is that divert attention. So these all the disintegrative effect may happen in the time of which episode? In the manifest conflict. When we behave violently, that time only the conflict may have disintegrative effects. Then healthy conflict help us to promote integration. Next, conflict and performance. So this is an important picture. Everyone should be learn about it. Is conflict cause the reducing the performance or not? Which degree of conflict promote integration and promote performance? Which degree of conflict cause the destruction and break down the relationship, reducing the performance? Look at this. This is bell curve. X-axis represent conflict, Y-axis represent performance. Look at this. There is no conflict. What will happen? There is no performance. Then increasing conflict gradually, performance also increasing. Then optimum level, which means moderate level of conflict, cause optimum performance. Then increasing the conflict, which leads to over conflict, which cause suffering and reducing the performance. Look at this. Too little conflict cause low performance. Too much conflict cause physical, mental suffering. Low performance. Little and medium conflict cause high level of performance. So the fact is that conflictless life is impossible. Everybody having experience in the conflict in everyday life, in family setting, in study setting, in occupational setting, okay? So our role is that managing the conflict and control it and try to promote integration and try to promote solidarity. So which help to improving performance in every setting. So students, the fact is that many of the people in our society, small conflict come in the life, maybe anxious as well as they do not accept the conflict. The reason is that they don't know about the reality of the social process. So we are nursing professional, we know about. So this knowledge help us to guidance give to the patients as well as health education give to the groups and families regarding the conflict and how to manage the conflict and maintain healthier lifestyle as well as maintain and promote every aspect of health. Next, difference between conflict and competition. Conflict involve contact. But competition does not. Second, conflict is conscious, but competition unconscious. Three, conflict intermittent process, competition continuous process. You know, every day we have been combat with each other. Fourth one, conflict is personalized, competition is impersonal. So reason is that every conflict started from an individual mind, which means that latent conflict within the mind, thinking about disagreement with others. Next question, is cooperation and conflict go together? Plus A, yes or no question? Plus C,
yes sir.
Is cooperation and conflict go together? Yes or no? Yes, 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 only yes, nice answer. Yes, plus C, is cooperation and conflict go together? Various study finding available. I going to explain. Cooperation and conflict are universal element in social life. According to Cooley, conflict and cooperation not separate. That's I was explained about. Where there cooperation available, there where we can see competition as well as conflict. Conflict is part of life. Our role is that managing the conflict, promote cooperation to develop self as well as groups and societies. Conflict, sum short, is the life of society and progress. As we have discussed, you know, the effect, relation between performance and conflict. Cooperation is a condition of conflict. It is difficult to eliminate conflict altogether from society. It's a contrast. It's where there cooperation, there where we can conflict. It's a difference between them. Next, war. Conflict between two nations. Definition, war. Mainly conflict between two countries or state, you know, or non-state actors characterized by violence, social destruction, economic destruction. Effect of war, cost of economy, loss, production, you know, killing soldiers, human suffering, psychiatric breakdown, etc. So war is a type of conflict between the countries or states or non-state actors. Next, accommodation. Accommodation is resolution of conflict. Definition, process in which man attains sense of harmony with his environment. You know, accommodation is a process, try to maintain harmony in the social situations. Characteristics, result of conflict. Students, a very conflict ended with accommodation, resolution of conflict. Second, unconscious activity. After the conflict, unconsciously this process will become and try to maintain solidarity in the new setting. Then it is universal, everywhere we can see. In family, in religion, in educational setting, in economic, you know, occupational setting, etc. Fourth one, it is a continuous process. Never stop, continuously happening this process. You know, cooperation, we had learned about, you know, every group started with cooperation. Members cooperate with each other. Then start competition. Over competition ended with conflict. Conflict ended with accommodation. So it is continuously happening in life setting. Every life situations. In familial, in occupational. Students mainly in the accommodation is that in occupational setting is very important to conflict resolution in the hospitals and conflict resolution in any organizations, healthcare organization as well as other organizations. Fifth one, mixture of both love and hatredness. The accommodation due to the immediately after the conflict. So having some love in new setting after the conflict and some hatred with disagreed people. Mainly this process we can see in this primary group level informally, accommodation. But in formal group, mainly organizational setting, accommodation process happening informally, defined how to solve a conflict between superior and subordinate, and how to solve the conflict between management and manage producers and laborers, or management and workers in the particular organization. Then methods of accommodation. So this method is very important for us. Ask in competitive examinations. So this knowledge should be used in the nursing management or administration. So mainly used in the conflict resolution methods. Another question is that conflict resolution methods. First method is that quiescence. Quiescence means forcefully solve the problem. I was given one illustration, you know, if two person done a job and 1,000 rupees, but person A earning 750 rupees, bring person B only 250 rupees. And to solve that problem, person A may be threatening person B. That is called coercion. Second one, compromise. Agreed to compromise, which means compromise means solve the problem through agreements. For example, that two persons discuss with each other and share the money equally and compromise the problems. So which is individual conflict, mainly in the formal organizational setting concerning the this compromise may be written format. Compromise between one party and first party and second party. Through legally solve the problem in through written documents. Then arbitration. Arbitration means use to solve the problem by using legislations. For example, some conflict not cure and not solve between two groups or between two individuals. That time third, you know, arbitration. Legislation can use to solve that problems. Law. Then conciliation. Attempts on the part of third party. So this type of conflict resolution we can see in hospital setting. For example, conflict between two nurses. Between superior nurse and subordinate nurse. Superior nurse says that a particular procedure only do as old method. But new nurse says that I have new method to do a particular procedure, which create conflict between superior nurse and subordinate nurse. What will happen? Third person will become there. Who is that person? Nursing superintendent will become there and discuss with each other what is the reality of the problem and which method is used best and easy. That method may be introduced to do a particular nursing procedure and to solve the problem. So that is called conciliation. Third person involved. Third party. Fifth one, toleration. The toleration is very, very important one. The reason is that I was given an idea. Every conflict started with a latent conflict, then felt conflict. Perceive conflict and felt conflict. When we perceive the conflict, what will you do? Just tolerate it and try to create a new environment to solve the conflict within that limit, within the felt or feeling. And don't go to manifest conflict. Don't go to this display behavior of conflict or manifest conflict. So that is called a tolerance. Clear about it? So don't go to behave to conflict, just within the, stop the conflict within the feeling and tolerate yourself. Sixth one, conversion. Conversion means change ideas. I was given one illustration, conflict between supervisory nurse and subordinate nurse. To solve the conflict, subordinate nurse maybe change their idea, convert their idea to adopt old method to do a particular nursing procedure to solve the problem. Seventh one, rationalization. Rationalization means think logically and want reason and evidence according to that to solve the problem, solve or resolve the conflict. Eighth one, subordination and subordination. So this type of method only we can see in the organizations. Subordination means the subordinate may come to solve this conflict. Subordination means superior. Nursing superintendent or supervisory nurses may come to solve the particular problem among the nursing, particular conflict among the nursing professionals in the hospital setting. So these are the methods of conflict resolution. So these are the conflict resolution methods. This is very important for examinations throughout our professional life. This is maybe used in hospitals, you know, hospital setting, and also in theoretical aspect, it is essential for nursing administration and management. Then assimilation. Assimilation we will learn next class, okay? So today we had a wonderful day. The reason is that many of them think about conflict. We do not accept the conflict, you know. Any conflict arise in our life, difficult to accept. But reality is that conflictless life is impossible. Conflict and cooperation go together. So anytime we have experiencing the conflict, use these methods and try to tolerate. Maybe a nursing professional need toleration to prevent the conflict and resolve the conflict. Okay, thank you. I would like to ask one question. Can you list what are the episode of conflict?
Latent conflict, perceived conflict, felt conflict, manifest conflict, conflict aftermath.
Yes, excellent. Thank you, Jefflin Shaija, for wonderful answer. Okay, anybody having any questions? Okay. Any question, feel free to ask. I always support you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy the day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bless you.